fire in the partner quiz than we did. We studied for like 6 hours last night.
Well, Kelly, I just kinda look at the problem and do it correctly.
What if we mess with them before the next test? We'll score better than they did.
Yeah, let's do it.
We can hear you.
No, you can't.
Kane, I bet we can score better than you on the next test.
Nuh-uh.
All right, Kane, we got this. You're on.
Hey, thanks for inviting us to come study for the next test.
Yeah, those velocity problems are a real doozy.
No problem, Michael. I wonder what your velocity would be if you fell into the pool.
To find the velocity that I fall into the pool, we first start with the position function y equals negative x squared plus x plus 6.5. We then set this equal to 0 and then find that the x value of at which I fall into the pool is negative 2.098. Then we take the derivative of the position function, which turns out to be negative 2x plus 1. We substitute in the x value, negative 2.098, and eventually come to our answer of 5.196 feet per second that I fall into the pool.
What a weird question to ask, Kelly.
Go.
What luck!
Really? Oh my gosh.
So how do we get back at them?
I don't know. Let's think.
Good kill.
I've got the best idea.
Oh yeah?
Okay. You know empty soda cans?
Uh-huh.
We could stack all these cans behind their door. In order to open their door to get into the room, they're gonna spray them all everywhere.
But where are we gonna get all those cans?
Cans? I'll show you cans.
Chug. Chug, chug. Good work. Chug.
So, to find out how fast I can drink a can of water, we're going to assume that dHdt is 3. We're going to try and find what dVdt is. So the equation for the volume of a cylinder is V equals pi r squared h. And we're going to take the derivative of that, and we're going to get pi, parentheses, 2r dr dt h plus r squared dHdt. Since dr dt is a constant, it is 0, and only r squared dHdt remains. When you substitute in the values 3.25 for the radius and 3 for the dHdt, you get dVdt equals 99.5472 milliliters per second.
So now what? I failed.
Sure did. Eureka!
What do girls hate?
I don't know.
Alien
ceramic
invasion.
Tiles!
Water!
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 Water balloons! It messes with their hair or something, right?
Yeah!
Where can we throw them?
We can throw them from up there!
Alright, let's do this.
Hey, wait a minute. I kind of wonder, how much water is actually going to get on Julie? Maybe if we measured the volume of this water balloon.
Sounds like a plan.
Alright!
To find the volume of the balloon that dropped on my head, we created points in a calculator that followed the curve and found a regression model. So y equals negative 0.261 x squared plus 1.451 x minus 0.0896. And then to find the volume, we use this method. So volume equals pi times the integral from 0 to 5.5 of our function squared dx. Then we use the calculator, and the volume is 33.805 inches cubed.
Oh my god, Julie, what happened? Why are you soaking wet?
I'm always just thinking.
There we go.
And that happened.
Oh, I can't believe they did that.
I know, now
we're
they hit
so
both of us.
Wet.
I'm so wet. Jesus.
Oh my god, that was freezing.
Ah! Oh my gosh, now it's like going down my shirt.
So to find the maximum rate at which my anger was increasing in terms of the number of sandwiches requested over time, we plotted points in our calculator and found the logistic model for our data, which is y equals 100.087 divided by 1 plus 1,151.204 e to the negative 1.409x. Then we took the derivative on our calculator and evaluated it at x equals 5 and got 35.256 sandwiches per second.
Oh, we got the same score.
Good job, guys.
At first I was afraid, what could the answer be? It said, given this position, find velocity. So I tried to work it out, but I knew that I was wrong. I struggled, I cried, a problem shouldn't take this long. I tried to think, control my nerve. It's evident that speed's tangential to that time-position curve. This problem would be mine if I just knew that tangent line, but what to do? Show me a sign. So I thought back to calculus, way back to Newton, and to Leibniz, and to problems just like this. Explained that when I had given up on physics, I said no. There's just one way to find that slope, and so now I'm
going
to find the derivative of x position with respect to time. It's as easy as can be, just have to take
yeah, the whole back.
Oh no!
I will derive. Hey, hey. And then I went ahead to the second part, but as I looked at it, I wasn't quite sure how to start. It was asking for the time at which velocity was at a maximum. And I was thinking, woe is me, but then I thought, this much I know.
Are you kidding me?
I've got to find the acceleration that is equal to zero.
Are you kidding me?
Now if I only knew what the
point
was.
Got it all.
I guess I'm gonna have to solve for it some way. So I thought back
That's a dot
to calculus, way back to Newton and to life.